Hello and a big welcome to all of you. Often an interview question which gets a little harder is whether you find this interesting, hard work or smart work. So what could be the option? In case if it comes to you, what would be your reply? Let's work it out for hard work or smart work. Let's understand that hard work or work hard versus work smart, what's the difference? Working hard and working smart are two approaches that can help to achieving your goals and finding success in your career. Choosing which approach to take may depend on your industry, objectives or preferences. In this particular shoot, we'll discuss the perceptions of working hard and working smart, the differences between the two processes and give tips on how you can get smarter, evolve from hard work. What is the perception of working hard? The term working hard doesn't have a concrete definition. Instead, the phrase has a perception or a list of attributed qualities associated with it. If others perceive you to be hardworking, you may start your days early and end them late. You may engage in physical labor or thought-intensive mental jobs. You may also put a lot of effort or endurance into completing tasks. Some may consider hard work jobs to be entry level or ones you take before advancing to less strenuous positions. What is the perception of working smart? If others perceive you to be working smart, you may constantly look for ways to innovate or save time. You may spend your time planning, networking or making deals. You may look for shortcuts or hacks to complete your goals more quickly and increase productivity. The perception of someone who works smart may differ depending on the individual or the industry. So, what is the difference between working hard and working smart? Identifying differences between working hard and working smart can be a challenge because both methods encourage employees to reach the same goals, personal and team success. The biggest differences may show in areas such as aim and process. Hard work often aims to increase production or quantity throughout the course of the project. Supervisors develop a reliable but repetitive method to achieve this aim, and employees work to follow that template to meet the goal. Smart work, in contrast, may aim to improve the quality of the final product or the process itself. Those engaging in small work may sacrifice time to test alternative theories or change a template to produce fewer but more targeted results. Second, concept. The concept of hard work may stem from tradition, especially in certain industries where doing things one way in a predictable manner has led to profitable results and satisfied customers. That you can succeed at hard work by learning a particular method and practicing it until you get it right may appeal to those who like rules, order, and mastery. Working smart may arise from a more experimental area that starts with a production method similar to hard work, but looks beyond current productivity and profit margins for ways to improve them and grow. Tips for working smarter. Use this tip, which will definitely help you to get more smarter and develop a growth mindset and transform your habits. What are they? Be innovative. Focus on innovating instead of staying complacent. Even if you and your team are already successful, consider ways to make improvements, add new ideas, and develop new products or procedures. Consider partaking in brainstorming sessions and recording ideas when they come to you to have a list of potential innovations to reference when making plans. Be selective. Be selective in the business opportunities you pursue. Choose ones that make the best use of your time and resources to increase productivity. Learn to take time to consider opportunities before agreeing to them and how to be comfortable passing chances that don't favor your needs or business model. Creative, deliver and capture value. Consider what makes your company valuable and has the biggest long-term impact on the business and work to capitalize on that in the creation, delivery and collection stages of production. You may increase the value of your products or services in the creation stage through innovation, share that value with consumers in the delivery stage through marketing and collect proof of value through invoicing in the capture stage itself. Do your research. Conduct market research and analyze to learn about industry trends. Consider searching for overlooked niches in the market on which you can capitalize. Before beginning a project, try making a flexible plan or outline to guide the execution stages, save time, and help avoid challenges later in the program. Join the right industry. Choose an industry that is both interesting to you and that has growth potential. Finding a balance between these two factors allows you to use the most of your knowledge and experience to achieve results. It may also help keep you eager to learn and keep expanding your value and industry presence. Learn life skills. Consider learning skills that come from sources other than the classroom. Pay attention to creating a healthy work-life balance, addressing your physical and mental health, learning how to manage money and building reliable support system. Feeling confident in your life skills outside of your company or business may give you more mental space to devote to working smarter. Learn to network and delegate. Working with others can help you learn new skills and share responsibilities to complete tasks more efficiently. Consider learning how to network with others to find new opportunities and potential business partners. You may also try assigning tasks to other employees or working in collaboration with co-workers to complete intricate or lengthy projects. Master time management. Working smart relies on knowing how to best allocate your time and resources. Consider discovering how you can eliminate distractions during your workday. You may also try setting up automated systems like instant email replies or auto-generated reports to save time on repetitive daily tasks. Set limits. You may work smarter by recognizing your personal and professional limits and sticking to them. Understand, when you have taken on as many tasks and you can handle successfully at one time and learn to be comfortable saying no or asking to revisit a project at a later time if you have already reached your capacity. Take breaks. Knowing when to walk away from a task to refocus your thoughts can help you work smarter. Giving yourself time to relax, clear your mind, and take a break helps your mental health and stress levels. It also allows you to come back to a project and notice things you missed before or come up with a new idea. Train your brain. Train your brain by developing your critical and creative thinking abilities. If you are curious enough, you would definitely be creative and definitely trigger more to critical thinking. Taking classes, doing independent research, paying attention to the world around you, taking notes, trying new things and testing new technology are all ways you can teach your brain to think analytically, which may help you work smarter through planning and project management. So with these guidelines, I'm sure that you would come to know hard work is what we all begin with, and there is no replacement to hard work whatsoever. Getting smarter over a period of time, you may need to apply all of these that I have just mentioned. So prepare your list and try to walk through that list. And while you're walking through, take care of the conscious being of yourself and try to evolve with an example. So once you are ready, coming hard way to smarter way, you will eventually pick up this good habit of working things smarter if you are applying all of these that I have mentioned. When it comes to answering this particular question in an interview, you should be smarter enough to say that you all begin with hard work, but you change the course, doing it much smarter when you get along by doing it more consciously, thoroughly following processes, following some kind of a set pattern, and then evolving yourself to call a smart worker. But remember, we all answer it that we are a smart worker. We don't know how to answer it. And I've just laid down a few things that makes you now to answer more confidently that you become a smart worker after doing a hard work. Hope this works a long way and a big way. Best wishes and thank you.